Well, another good month to report for Greg Blanchard, down about a dozen more pounds and almost ready to venture outside for a stroll. He started his journey last fall at 804 pounds. On the left is then, and on the right is now, more than 250 pounds later. The roller coaster of extreme weight loss is a wild ride, and Greg admits there's more to it than just what he eats. Jennifer Vaughn has more.
A gray, chilly May day keeps us in this month, even though Greg wanted to take his first ever stroll down the street outside his home. Instead, he works on another muscle, his brain.
You know, we're sort of their tour guide, if you will, through their journey, and we get to walk alongside of them and experience the process with them, and hopefully along the way be able to point out any barriers or roadblocks that might come into play and work with them on how to manage that a little bit better.
Kristen Cornelis is Greg's mental health counselor. They've been working together for months now, but Greg admits he wasn't the most eager of patients.
I had such that negative image of needing a mental health counselor that I was actually offended going when she's like, I'm going to make another appointment. And I'm like, well, I only thought this was a one-time thing.
Now he looks forward to their appointments every 2 weeks. Once he could admit the toll his weight and lifestyle had taken on his psyche, Greg agreed to dig in and get to work.
She's beginning to help me now see that I'm beginning to like the person that I am finally. It's been a long time since I've actually felt good about myself.
With Kristen's help, Greg is building the tools he'll need to actually see and enjoy his tremendous transformation. It had been years since Greg could do even the most simple of tasks. Now he's down 253 pounds. He can walk, do the dishes, and stand on his own. He knows this, but he doesn't always feel it. A block of sorts that is common for people who lose extreme amounts of weight.
I think it's something that happens progressively over time, that things start to feel more congruent, that we start to see, you know, people start to see themselves more in line with who they are. And it takes time and it takes work to achieve that.
A bad weigh-in that would have normally destroyed me before, but, you know, now it's taking the positive side of that and not getting down on myself for that.
Greg is also slowly unraveling a lifetime's worth of pain. He calls it chipping away at a block of ice, a little at a time, because the hurt runs deep. Decades of being overweight, losing his independence, relying on his wife to survive, the issues that got him to 804 pounds are still there, but they're starting to melt. He promises me that by next month, we'll take our walk, and he'll be smiling the whole way.
My cheery personality will still hopefully be here.
For more information on Greg's transformation so far, he is down an astonishing 267 pounds to date. And the Mental Health Center of Greater Manchester, you can check WMUR.com and click on Health. Jennifer Vaughn, WMUR News 9.